Hallelujah. So let's open our Bible to what we are talking today. Just get your Bible ready, the book of 1 John, chapter 3, verse 4. So our topic for today is the thing called sin. The thing called sin. So what is sin? Because someone out there will like to know this. That no, I think what I'm doing is right. I think this is right. So I don't think I've sinned against God. But this morning we'll go through this so that we learn from the Word of God. Just briefly, what is sin? Now, the book of 1 John chapter 3, verse 4 say, everyone who is a sinner goes against the law, for sin is going against the law. Which law? The law of God. Hallelujah. So once you begin to go against the law of God, you have sinned. So sin is actually anything contrary to the Word of God. Anything that God said don't do, if you do that, you have sinned. So that is how you understand sin. If God said don't drink, and you God don't do this, and you want to justify yourself, you have sinned against God. So, to understand it easily, anything that God said don't do, and you do it, you have sinned. Now, we have our biological parents. If they say don't steal sugar and you steal sugar, you have sinned. It's wrong. Yes. And again, I believe you have understood that part. Sin is a transgression or disobedience against God's word or against God's law. I think it's in the book of Deuteronomy chapter number 28. If we read it, there is a scripture that say, if you obey this book and you do according to what it says, then all these blessings will come upon you. But if you go contrary to this book, if you sin against my laws, then all these curses shall come upon you. So we can see there that the blessings and curses were all linked to the good and the bad you do. So anything bad is sin, yes. And everything good, if it good, it should be from the Holy Spirit. It should come from God and it should be right. You don't need to be told what is wrong. Your conscience will also tell you that something is wrong with you. Something is wrong with what you are doing. And the Holy Spirit speaks a lot to us. And most of the time you obey and you see how God rescue us from sin. Sin is anything that comes from the devil. And it's a form of rebellion against God. I believe you understand this. So now somebody will also say, I have sinned. What must I do? Yes, I did wrong. What must I do? Should I remain with my wrongs? Should I remain with evil that I have committed? No. As long you are alive, there is hope for you. But this hope does not mean that you have to abuse it. When you have done what is wrong, you need to stop immediately and repent. So what must I do now that I know that I have sinned? The answer is repent. So in the book of Acts chapter 2 verse 38 says, and Peter said, let your heart be changed, and every one of you, and have baptism in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of sins. So we can see here that once we do something which is wrong, there is still hope, there is still a way for you. And that is through repentance. You repent of your sin. And then if you take John chapter 1 verse 12, say, for them that received him, he gave them power and right to become the children of God. So in other translations say power and some say right. So you have that link with your Father. When you repent of your sin, it means you have received him back. And when you receive him back, You are given that right to become the child of God. So you are not like others. You are a child of God. So, but if you are now in the world and you say, okay, now I know that everything that I've been doing, this and that is a sin, is wrong. What you do next is to repent of your sin. You confess your sins to God. Lord, I did this A, B, C, D, and I acknowledge this to be wrong before you. Please forgive me. Your Father in heaven, your God, who was not your God then, because you have other gods, you know, the devil. Jesus said, your father is the devil because of the works that you do. Now that you are changing fathers to come to your heavenly Father, and you confess your sins, God become your Father. And he will say, my son, my daughter, you are welcome to my kingdom. You are now my child. You are now my daughter. You are now my son. That what a joy. It's such a glorious thing when you are a child of God and when your sins are forgiven. So, to understand it easily, when you repent of your sin, whether you were a child of God and you backslid, you went back to the world, or you were in the world and you are now repenting of your sins, your sins will be forgiven and your name will be written in the book of life. And that's again, repentance and confessions of your sins. It has to do with your heart. You can just say with your mouth, but your heart does not agree with what you are saying. It doesn't help you. You need to mean what you say. You need to believe that what you have done is wrong and what you are confessing is right. And God will forgive you. Yes, God will forgive you. He will not throw you away. When you repent of your sins, he forgives you. Hallelujah. So now somebody will say, now that I am born again, what must I do? Now that I have repented, what must I do? So the answer is simple. Continue to walk in the way of the Lord. Continue to walk in the way of the Lord. So there are ways of the devil, and you need to reject that because it's where you are coming from. The fact that you repent is because you were a sinner. You were doing something that God did not want you to do. And now that you come into the way of the Lord, you need to continue to walk in the way of the Lord. Continue to walk in the way of the Lord. So Philippians chapter 2 verse 12 say, so then my loved ones, as you have at all times done what I say, not only when I'm present, but now much more when I'm not with you, give yourselves to working out your salvation with fear in your heart. So work on your salvation with fear in your heart. Protect it. Don't let the devil steal your light. Don't let the devil misguide you, deceive you by his evil spirits and evil doctrines and evil things of this world. So there is hope for you as long you are alive. You can repent of your sins. You can come back. Maybe you were backslidden. You can come back to the Lord and repent your sins and repent from your sins. Or you were not born again. The fact that you hear this message, it means God is talking to you. Just repent of your sins. Accept that what you have been doing is wrong, and your sins will be forgiven when you confess them from your heart. So this morning, let us pray together and let's hope and believe that your sins will be forgiven. And from this very moment, you will become a child of God again. My Father, thank you for the word of today. Thank you for the Bible. Thank you for the word of life. Many are there outside condemning themselves of what they have been doing or what they have done before, and Satan is telling them this and that. Now that they have heard the word of God, please speak to their heart so that they repent of their sins and come back to Jesus Christ, the hope of glory. And there may be those ones that have not given their heart to Jesus before. Please, Jesus, speak to their heart now. Speak to their heart. Bring hope into their mind. Bring hope into their spirit so that they too repent of their sins and become children of God. The Lord Jesus Christ touch you now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you.